Okay. So, here's one of my problems. About 5 o'clock today, I was so tired that I could not keep my eyes open long enough to concentrate on anything, and kept catching myself falling asleep while attempting to focus on something. And when I am that tired, the only thing I can do that makes any sense is sleep. Because if I try to force myself to stay awake through whatever caffeine or what have you, no matter what I do to try to stay awake, it's pretty much guaranteed to give me a headache. And then I'm going to end up lying down to sleep off the headache anyways. Why was I so tired that I could not keep my eyes open at 5 o'clock? Well, a combination of things. I actually had slept enough the night before that I should not have been that tired. And I have not done anything strenuous today. But my spine was still giving me problems. I was starting to get a headache. And it's gotten really cold and damp outside as I've recorded. And that, apparently, makes me feel not only exhausted, but so sleepy I can't keep my eyes open. And that is one of the problems that I have with maintaining a regular sleep schedule, is once I'm in enough pain, the only thing my body really wants to do is sleep. And unless you load me up with caffeine, which has a consequence, nothing is really going to keep me awake. And if you do try to load me up with caffeine, all I get is a horrible headache that won't go away until I lie down anyways. That's reason, like, number one, on top of the insomnia, why I don't have a regular sleep schedule. And I did try. Like I said, I had a regular sleep schedule for like 2 weeks. And then this. I've also come to notice that light is only bright enough to block by effectively if I'm actually facing that way. Otherwise, half my face is in shadows. And every time I block the light from my eyes, my face is in shadows. I really need to work on that. I need to find a light that's bright enough to block by that isn't going to stab me in the eyes. It's going to be a challenge. There is a video of explanation that I intended to make probably a long time ago, because for a number of reasons, mostly to refer people to instead of re-explaining myself repeatedly. But it's not really a happy subject. It's more a subject of necessity, and I don't want to bring anyone down, and yet it is a sincere video, so as much as I might want to present it in a creative means that isn't going to make anybody's day less happy, there's really no better way for me to say this stuff than to just block at you like this. Some of you may already know, or may have been referred here, because you know that I get headaches. Now, when I say I get migraines, what I mean is I get migraine-like headaches, which means I get all of the symptoms of a very severe migraine. It does not, however, mean that I get headaches because of the same causes as migraine sufferers. So telling me to avoid aged cheese and red wine and to just, you know, take the same medications as migraine sufferers does not actually help me. Migraines, specifically as they're understood by science today, are caused by blood vessels expanding or contracting in the brain. Now, while I do get some headaches that seem to be triggered by that sort of thing, taking the medication intended to help those headaches does not help my headaches. It can actually trigger some of the worst migraines I have ever had. And a lot of the tannins in food that people with migraines are sensitive to, I'm actually not. I did avoid aged cheese and aged meat and red wine for a long time because I've tried everything I could to try to get rid of these headaches and noticed no difference at all with avoiding those foods. The foods I have noticed a difference with avoiding are MSG and other similar molecules, any artificial sweeteners, and also coloring agents. Basically anything with an excitotoxic effect, or an artificial sugar. Avoiding those has lessened the migraines slightly. One issue I've run into now, though, is now that I'm not used to having them in my system at all, I'm really sensitive. So if somebody convinces me to eat something that only has trace amounts in it, or they don't know what's in it, or they lie to me about what's in it, I end up getting the worst splitting headache ever. Which is why I'm so picky about the food that I eat. Not only do I not want to eat excitotoxins and end up, you know, exacerbating, like, brain chemistry issues and cancer, I don't want to be in excruciating pain. That's why I'm difficult and picky. And I'm not just being picky. There's a legit allergy-type reason for me not wanting to eat those foods. One of the most annoying things about the headaches, though, is that they do not only have that one cause. I get headaches for a lot of different causes, and when any of those headaches are left to aggravate me for long enough, through tension or whatever else, they develop into migraine-type headaches. And I don't just get migraine symptoms when I have a migraine-type headache. I get extremely bad migraine symptoms. And maybe not so much the actual throwing up that some people experience, but a lot of the sense problems. Like, I lose my sense of hearing after a while. And before I actually stop being able to hear, long before that, I lose my ability to interpret what I am hearing. I hear sounds, and they're probably words, but either because there's actually pressure on the language center in my brain, or because I'm just in that much pain, I cannot make heads or tails of what's being said to me. And it's a problem, because one of the reasons why the headaches are such a big deal is because they escalate to that point where my senses are literally shutting off, and I cannot work. I cannot just have a high pain tolerance, which I do, and push through the pain, because it's not just pain. It's me quite literally unable to see or hear. I lose my vision, too. First, everything gets fuzzy, and, you know, there's the light and the sound sensitivity, which just makes it hurt to see lights and hear sounds. But then my vision starts getting really fuzzy. I start getting, like, blotchy colors. It kind of looks like fractals. You know, like electric sheep. Have you ever seen those? But not the pretty flowery ones, just the kind of random ones. And then slowly more and more my vision tunnels and other stuff from adrenaline, and at some point, I can hardly see in flashes. It's not like my eyes go black or blank, but basically all I'm able to get are really bright glares of this or that when I force my eyes open. And can my brain actually make heads or tails of what I'm seeing? After a while, no. No. If the headache gets anywhere near this bad, I have to crawl up in a dark, warm corner and hope I can fall asleep before I go insane from the amount that my head hurts. And they haven't determined the exact cause of me getting headaches that bad. They should have by now observed that sometimes they can last for, not quite at that level, but at a level that's very ready to escalate to that if aggravated, like a normal migraine level, for months at a time. Which is why I stopped working. And part of why I no longer work. Part of the issue is, as I started saying earlier, so many things start headaches for me. If I sneeze, that can start a headache for me. Not only that, but at some point it seems like my nerves and my brain got crossed. And literally, every time I have to sneeze now, I don't feel like I have to sneeze. I feel like I have to throw up. Like, really strongly, only I've been able to tell when it's a, I've learned to tell when it's a sneeze. And I'm like, oh my god, I think I'm actually gonna be sick. And then I sneeze. It's like, oh, that's what that was. Okay. That only started happening, like, 3 years ago. And now it won't stop. My body thinks I'm going to throw up every time I need to sneeze. And like I said, if I sneeze enough, it triggers headaches. Being out in the sun, massive trigger for headaches. Like, I feel like I'm having a heat stroke after, like, I don't know, 10 minutes. I cannot have sun on the back of my neck, for one. Or I will be, like, I will start to shake and, like, fall over. Which is another one of those reasons why I avoid the sun and refuse to try to get a tan, because no, that will not solve. I also get headaches from blood pressure. My blood pressure likes to sit between 60 over something and 90 to 100-ish over something. It's usually in the 87 to 90-ish range for the top number and 100-ish. On the bottom number. And for me, that is normal. And when it spikes up higher than that, I tend to get headaches and nosebleeds. Because it doesn't slowly, healthily raise higher than that and then stay there. It spikes higher than that. It shoots up and back down. That also gives me disease bugs. Another thing my blood pressure likes to do is drop as low as, like, 60-something over 40-something, which is literally half of normal. And when you see people trying to show that characters on TV are dying from blood loss and such, that's the kind of reading they give you for they're almost dead. I don't know how accurate that is medically, but the fact that my blood pressure will just drop that low and stay there for no apparent reason concerns me. Doesn't seem to concern my doctor, and I'm not sure if that's because he doesn't believe me, but it does also trigger headaches, which is a problem. Poor air quality, because I can't breathe properly, or things that I'm allergic to contaminating the air, like cigarette smoke, make me cough because I can't breathe properly, or my lungs and throat are swelling. And if I cough too much, I get a splitting headache. And it's light, too much bright light, whether or not I already have a headache, will cause me to get a headache. Too much muscle tension will cause me to get a headache. One of the issues I have with that is that once my muscles get tense, they don't actually like to relax at all. So muscle tension is a huge issue for me. I'm constantly having to do things to try to avoid muscle tension, because if I get too tense, I'll get a headache. And as I said, anytime I start getting a headache, for whatever reason, even just being really physically uncomfortable will give me a headache. It, with like any normal level of light and sound, like being at work, for example, will quickly escalate into a migraine. Sometimes there's not even an apparent trigger. I just randomly start getting a headache, and if I'm out in public, it quickly escalates, and then all of a sudden, I'm incapacitated, vulnerable, and might not be able to hear or see properly, which is why I can't get my driver's license, or shouldn't be allowed to, legally, because I can suddenly be blind and deaf for no apparent cause at random. And why I'm not entirely comfortable going out in public, especially alone. It does come off like mild agoraphobia, but I have a reason for it. I don't want to suddenly be vulnerable and alone in public. It got really bad once I got used to having somebody live with me and be with me constantly, and then they were gone. And it's gotten a little better now that I have a cell phone, because I can reach into my pocket, press a button, and ask somebody to come save me if something does go wrong, which makes me feel better. But it's not just headaches. It's like I said, I also have a really bad problem with muscle tension and random muscle spasms, and the more stressed I get, stress which also triggers headaches, the worse my nerve problems get. And it's not just spasms or occasionally accidentally throwing things across the room because my nerves just freaked out. It's also pain. Random stabbing pain in places. And part of one of the problems seems to be that my muscles like to let my the discs in my spine slip out of place, which not only can put fluid pressure on the brain and cause headaches, but causes, like, nerve pinching that goes everywhere in my body. My sciatic nerve likes to pinch off sometimes. Other nerves like to pinch off. My spine has gotten really, really fond of disaligning somewhere between my shoulder blades and putting pressure on the nerve that controls my heart and or lungs, so I'll get heart palpitations or not be able to breathe properly. And this really likes to happen if I'm laying on my back for too long. My spine, like I said, gets really angry about it and then takes it out on my lungs. So if I lay there too long, I can't breathe right. I've noticed this can be resolved by lying there with a slight twist, like not quite being on my back, so I'm kind of like on an angle that seems to keep it from becoming as much of an issue. But again, I have to be careful how I lay at night or I won't be able to breathe properly. I'm pretty sure that's a health concern, but again, my doctor never seemed particularly bothered by that. I do have a new doctor. And I do have a neurologist now, so we'll see how that goes. Another issue that I have is that my sense of smell and taste will literally, for like whole periods of time, hypersensitize to specific tastes. Like, one of the ones is the taste of corn-derived sugar. So that sometimes, for long periods of time, no matter what I'm eating, it tastes like either popcorn or marshmallows. It's just like a month. The only things that have flavor at all taste like popcorn or marshmallows. And the tea I drink all the time and normally love just tastes like dirty dishwater. Like, everything else just tastes bland and like nothing. I don't know what causes that. My doctor doesn't seem to know or care what causes that, but it's kind of a problem. It's annoying. It's hard to motivate yourself to get up and make something healthy to eat when you're in pain and you know everything you're going to eat is going to taste like dirty dishwater. One of the not so negative things that I get, I guess it's mixed blessing, is, and I'm not sure whether it directly has to do with the headaches or not, but I've always had a really strong sense of smell and really good sense of hearing. And, like, I've also had good peripheral vision and night vision. And that's useful enough, which is nice, but when I'm stressed, hypersensitive hearing. And then, as I've described before, I can hear beetles chewing on leaves. I can hear my neighbors flicking light switches through the floor. I can hear people getting up in the middle of night to make sandwiches and hear what kind of sandwiches they're making sometimes based on what containers they're opening. And that's an issue because when I'm stressed, I'm a very light sleeper, so I will just wake up to the sound of somebody making a peanut butter and mayonnaise sandwich and then not be able to get back to sleep. Because another problem I have is intermittent insomnia. When I can sleep a lot. When I can't sleep, maybe 3 hours at a time, if I'm lucky. And my body will want to do that for months at a time. And then it'll want to sleep for 10 hours at a time, for months at a time. And what makes this a lot worse is when you try to medicate me. Because another problem that I have is a really fast metabolism, and I think I'm starting to get the impression that my body has a problem responding normally to certain neurochemicals, especially dopamine. Because opiates, like morphine and oxytocin, all of those things, have no effect on me. No pain-relieving effect at all. And any mood stabilizer they've put me on has caused a slew of really bad side effects to hit me like a rock, and none of the actual effect that they're supposed to do. In fact, almost no medications have any effect on me, except muscle relaxants have a little bit of an effect. Adrenaline inhibitors have a little bit of an effect, like the one in Tremacet specifically. Anti-inflammatories bring down inflammation. Antihistamines, if they're strong enough, can help with an allergic reaction, and antibiotics, because it's not up to my body, it's up to the bacteria, are generally effective against bacteria, but I'm allergic to the two largest families of them, being sulfates and anything related to penicillin or amoxicillin. So I'm very hard to medicate, which is part of why the medical system seems to be really tired of me, when I go in and I need surgery, they can't give me morphine. They can't give me anything to any pain-relieving effect at all, except an anti-inflammatory, which makes you bleed more, so they don't like doing that. They pretty much always send me home with a painkiller that I cannot have, that I cannot take, that has no effect. There's no point in me taking, so I'm used to just not taking painkillers after surgery. I recover well. I'm good. Actually, aside from the problem with really horrid headaches all the time, I'm the model of perfect health. If I could exercise without pissing off my blood pressure and getting a horrible headache, if I could really exercise, I would probably be the most healthiest fit person I know. But I can't, because the headaches. Main issue in my life that these headaches cause is, even though in between these headaches I am the model of health, intelligence, and capability, because I get headaches so often, no one will keep me hired. Nobody is going to put up with somebody who just randomly misses work all the time when they have other people who also have a high school level education and can do the job well enough, who can be counted on to be in all the time. So, this is part of why I have to explain myself so much, is society today is obsessed with having a certain lifestyle, being like the morning to night work day or weird shifted work, but having a regular job and earning your money that way. And if you don't earn your money that way, people hold you in contempt and ask you to constantly justify yourself. And I get a little tired of it because I don't not have a job because I don't want to work. I loved working. I like having money. I like making obscene amounts of money and then being really good with it and saving up obscene amounts of money. I want to be rich before I'm 30. Like, so rich I'll never have to work again. I want to, like, earn and save up that much money. I like earning it. It feels good to... there isn't very much in life I derive satisfaction from, but earning money is one of them. And I can't do that now. And it's not because I'm not willing to work when I'm well enough in between the headaches. It's because nobody is willing to keep me hired. And I can't blame them. They're trying to run a business, and I'm missing work constantly without warning. But because of that, I cannot hold a regular job. And any time I try to set something up so that I am making money on my own time, those efforts are constantly being frustrated. And then when I explain that I am on the system and disability won't accept me because my doctors haven't figured out the actual cause of the headaches, so won't attest strongly enough that, yes, this person has headaches for this diagnosis. I don't have a diagnosis. My doctors can say, yes, this person can't work, yes, she has these symptoms, but they can't give a diagnosis, so disability won't accept me. So I'm just on the system. And it drives me crazy. I never had any money. People judge me constantly. I'm sick of it. I could do without this, but I can't do anything about it. I can't work. And so, being as I'm being supported by the taxpayers' money right now, that's actually one of the reasons why I want to do our work and blog and do things that could possibly entertain someone or enrich their lives or help them learn from my experience whenever I can. Because I want to give something back to the world. Hence me making this video. It's not just poor me, pity me. I love life. I really do. I would live forever still if I could. That's part of one of the reasons why I tend to live as though I might have a quickly approaching expiry date. It's not because I necessarily do. I don't think that I do. I'm pretty sure I'm going to live a fairly long time. I don't know what's wrong, so I don't know whether or not it comes with an expiry date. And I want to live forever, so whatever time I have, I feel like that's just not going to be enough. So if I'm having issues with people, I want it resolved now. I don't have a lot of patience to wait around for someday it might get better. If something in my life is bothering me, I want to make it better. That's one of the quirks of my character. And if I want something, I kind of tend to go for it, because I want to experience things that I want to in life. Which is part of why I do writing in my artwork, and I'm trying to cultivate feedback right now, because my next plan B was to self-publish and write books and earn an income that way. And if that fails for whatever reason, I will keep trying to find ways to support myself and make money. Because, yeah. I want to make lots of money and have lots of money to do stuff that I want to in life. Whether that be the next 5 years, or the next 1,000 years, or forever. I like experiencing things, and I want to share my experience with other people. And I want to give back to society. I would also like to be allowed to provide for myself, earn my own money, and be treated with that same respect that everybody else gets to. That would be nice. But in the absence of that, because society and the way it's set up is what is not letting me hold a job and what is frustrating my attempts to care for myself, I do feel it is at least fair that they are picking up the slack and going, well, here, we're not letting you earn your own money, but we'll at least give you money to live off of until we can work this out. That much I feel is fair, but I still want to be doing something to give back in exchange for this money. Besides that, people like to look at me like I'm lazy or have a poor work ethic because I'm sick so much and need to rest so much, but the exact opposite is true. I actually have a very good work ethic and really like getting stuff done. I can't stand sitting there and not feeling like I'm accomplishing anything. I can't just sit there and watch TV. If I'm watching TV, I'm doing it while painting or sculpting or creating something. Or at very least, I have to be thinking about like 50 different things. Possibly writing a book. Possibly writing a review or some kind of social commentary. My body has to be still sometimes, but it doesn't like to be still. And my brain never has to be still and never likes to be still. And it likes to go at a mile a minute. And I actually have ADD. It's not ADHD, and I've learned to cope with it by selectively hyper-focusing a lot. People have still noticed I have some of the short-term memory issues of a person with ADD, because you can't completely manage that disorder. Actually, I have a lot of mild symptoms of any disorder that has to do with your brain not responding to dopamine properly or not having enough dopamine to respond to. Which is why I think the issue is really with my dopamine receptors, because that would help to explain why opiates aren't so effective on me. But I have to talk to my neurologist about that, and a lot of the things that could be wrong aren't really expressing themselves in any way except with headaches, which is kind of not normal for a lot of the disorders that I might have. So, basically figuring out what's wrong might take putting my full genetic code through this new analyzing thing they can do to map out your whole genetic code and looking at it directly to figure out what the healthy issue is, seeing what mutations of what genetics I have that are causing an abnormality. And that's expensive, and nobody wants to do that unless it's absolutely necessary. Another thing that causes headaches is I have what are called low-lying cerebellar tonsils, or a Chiari type 2 malformation. Basically, the tonsils at the back of my brain are too long and like to pinch in the top of my neck. That does sometimes contribute to the headaches. And it makes it worse when I have tension or pressure in my spinal fluid, because it kind of just compounds the problem. Is it causing most of my headaches? No. Is it causing enough of the problem that it's worth risky brain surgery to try to fix it? No, I don't think so, and my neurologist agrees with me. But it is there. It's not like there is no physical evidence of any of these headaches. And I am, again, trying to address this with my neurologist, and I will be trying to address these issues with my new doctor. So, basically, that's what's going on with me, and that is my mission statement. In the time between headaches, when I am a person who likes to get stuff done and hates sitting on my ass doing nothing, I will try to do whatever I can that seems useful. Especially cultivating skills and a market audience, so that anything that I can produce, I can market and try to make money off of to support myself. So yeah, that's basically the gist of this video, is this is why I don't work, this is why I'm here, this is what I would like to do, and please, if you know who I am, and you happen to live someplace locally, and I can't give out my location online for security reasons, security issues that have been reinforced before, but if you know me and know where I am, and happen to run a business around here, or happen to have the power to employ me to do something useful through the internet and pay me for it, and are reputable enough that I would trust you to do that, hire me. I have time on my hands between the headaches, and if it's work that I can do on my own schedule, I am willing to do it. Barring the headaches, I'd be willing to do it on your schedule. And yeah, if you want to hire me, that would be fantastic. I have my high school diploma. I have knowledge and understanding of things beyond a high school diploma, but I don't actually have paperwork for it. I'm a quick learner. I figure stuff out easily. I have an above average IQ. I'm generally ambiguous about that because I don't want to make this like a competition or offend anyone or make anyone feel put off, but I have an above average IQ. When I'm not disabled by headaches, I am quite physically capable. I can do good work. And I would be very thankful to somebody if they could give me something that I could actually do. As unreliable as I can be for health reasons, and pay me for that. That would be great. Ow. So I'm probably gonna end up editing this because it's probably too long and there's probably unnecessary snippets in it. But anyway, see, like I have to stop turning that way because the lighting is bad when I turn that way. But yes. So now that my sleep schedule has been upset, oh god, am I achy and sore. I can keep trying to sleep all night and just get up ridiculously early in the morning and try to resume the same schedule. Or I may find myself unable to sleep and just have to get up now and say fuck having a regular schedule. But it's not like I don't try. I suppose all the bullshit people try to feed me about what they think are causing my problems should really be a separate video. But yeah, people like to try to tell me that the reasons why I get headaches all the time and I'm not well is because I don't sleep regularly. It's like, no. I don't sleep regularly because I am not well and get headaches all the time. And I try to keep it from being a cycle, but there is only so much I can do without being in excruciating pain, so lay off. Just lay off. You don't know my life situation better than I do. And quite frankly, the judgment is hurtful and uncalled for. So, yes. I will blog it to you later.